Guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how to mine Qubic on OctaSpace. And like everything else on OctaSpace, it's super simple. But before we jump into the actual guide, let me quickly introduce Qubic for those of you who might not be familiar with it. So Qubic is a layer one blockchain project with its own native coin called Qubic, also referred to as an energy unit, which is central to its utility. It uses something called useful proof of work, or UPOW for short. Unlike traditional proof of work systems where miners solve arbitrary puzzles, Qubic miners, or computers as they like to be known, perform useful tasks with a strong focus on AI training. These computers compete by running machine learning tasks, and the ones that achieve the best performance scores and rewards. In addition, these nodes periodically allocate mining hash rate to XMR mining and share the rewards from mined XMR. So essentially, the Qubic mining works across both GPU and CPU, periodically switching between the two. There's a lot more to Qubic, and I highly recommend checking out their documentation. I'll leave a link down below in the description. This is just scratching the surface. The project is gaining traction in the crypto space and has a growing community, so definitely check it out if you're interested. All right, now let's get into the tutorial. Before you can start mining Qubic, you'll need to set up a wallet. Head over to wallet.qubic.org. Once you've created your wallet, click on the QR code and copy the wallet address. Okay. Next, you'll need to mine through a pool. Mining with a pool means you're working with other miners to collectively find solutions and share the rewards. When one miner in the pool achieves a higher score in their AI task, the reward is distributed among all pool members based on a contribution. Since we focus on making everything simple, we have integrated the miner to use pool.qubic.li. So you'll want to initially create an account here and you'll sign in. Once signed in, you'll see the dashboard page and it'll show you your current history and what phase it is in. So currently we can see on the screen, it's mining the XMR phase. But again, it will then later switch to the actual Qubic phase for the AI training. Afterwards, you're going to want to expand the menu and go to settings. And here, you'll want to paste the Qubic wallet address. Next, you'll want to actually generate an access token because you're going to need this for the miner. So click on generate token. Okay, now we have a token generated. We have everything ready. Let's actually run the miner. So head over to OctaSpace Marketplace at marketplace.octa.space and create an account. Or if you already have one, just log in. Before launching the miner, make sure you have some credits on the platform. If not, click the top up button in the top right hand corner. You can deposit either native Octa, wrapped Octa, or USDT and USDC via the ETH or BSC networks. Okay, so when you initially come to the marketplace, you'll be redirected to the apps page, where you can see a list of one-click applications available on the platform. Select the mining category, then choose Qubic Client. You'll be taken to the node selections page. Here, choose one or more nodes to run the miner. Qubic supports most modern NVIDIA RTX GPUs. The more powerful the GPU and CPU combination, the better the hash rate, and ultimately the higher the rewards. For this demo, I'll pick a high spec node, so let's have a look. So I'll pick an RTX 5090. But feel free to go with something more affordable, like an RTX 3070 or better. You can use the filter menu on the left-hand side to refine your selection. Once you've selected your node, click Configure. On the configuration page, you'll need to add two environmental variables. As you can see, they've already been added for you here, so you'll just need to paste in the values. So in this case, we're going to paste in the token that we generated from the pool. And then all we have to do is click deploy. Okay, now we can see the client is running. it's going to initially download the container, and we can see the progress here. And once it's ready, it will actually display the actual information of what's going on here. So if we go back to system settings and while we monitor the container, if the container hasn't downloaded previously on this node, it might take about a couple of minutes for it to download. Okay, now we can see it's downloaded. We go over here into container logs. We can now actually see the miner running. We can even maximize it to full screen if we want to. But yep, now it's running. So all we have to do now is go back to the pool, and on the pool dashboard, we'll actually see active trainers. This will display after a couple of minutes. So give it 5 minutes or so for it to display. And we can also track it here on trainers, and we'll be able to see the actual node and how many shares it submitted, as well as XMR shares. So right now it's currently in the XMR phase. So if we go back here, you can actually see it's running the XMR mining. I'll pause this video and show when it's running the other miner as well. So when it switches back from XMR. Okay, now we can see it switched to a different mining phase and it's using the GPU. And if we go back to the mining pool and refresh, we can now see the current training phase. And we could go to trainers and we can see monitor our training. So just some more information around the pool. The pool uses a pay per share model and rewards are paid out once a week. So you may not see revenue show up immediately. In relation to the actual payouts, Qubic has a weekly payout system. So every week, a new batch of Qubic coins is created. And from that, rewards are distributed to miners. So each mining week is called an epoch, ends on a Wednesday at 12 p.m. After that, the system takes some time to process and verify all the AI training results submitted by miners. Once everything is checked, your payout will show up in your payout history with a pending status. Normally, your Qubic will be sent to your wallet by Friday night. Okay, so you can also add as many nodes as you want. So if you wanted to increase your potential training rewards, you can actually rent multi-GPU setups, so you can rent as many as you want. So let's do that now. So if we go back to the apps and click mining and select Qubic Client. Okay, let's say theoretically I wanted to rent all these 5090s. So I can actually click all of them at once. And we can click configure. And then all we have to do is just paste the access token again. And just press deploy. And now we can see all those miners are going to load up. So we can monitor the Docker containers again. And we can see it's already running. And again, it will take some time for them to show up on this page. So give it 5 minutes or so. And now we can see 5 active trainers. If we go back to the trainers section, we can now see all of our trainers are listed, which falls in line with the actual sessions that we have. And that's pretty much all there is to it. We'll drop all the relevant links in the description below. If you run into any issues, feel free to reach out to us on Discord. Make sure to like and subscribe so you don't miss any future tutorials as we continue to add more features to our market.